You read that in your Bible? Do you read that in your Bible? Book of Ezekiel,
yeah.
Chapter 20.
But righteousness is also as much of a free gift as faith is in the Christian understanding. Righteousness is a gift from God, just like eternal life is a gift from God. So we don't have righteousness on our own.
When you compare, my sister, look, you see, the Christian world has really gone down the drain, according to Jimmy Swaggart. According to his books, you must read them. If you haven't got them, you must get them. On sodomy, homosexuals, get that. On pornography, get it. On incest, get it. On alcohol, get it. And he's telling you, America, he's telling America, he says, America, he says, God must judge you. And if he doesn't, he said, he might have to apologize to Sodom and Gomorrah for what he did to them. This is Jimmy Swaggart talking. This is where you have gone. After 2,000 years of Christianity. Look, you're sodomites. Here in New York, you have 1 million more women than men. If every man in New York gets married, there'll be 1 million women who can't get husbands. Here. And out of your manpower you have here, 1/3 are gays, sodomites. 1/3 are gays. Your prison population, 98% are men. And men will have cold feet for so many different reasons. Can you imagine your problem? There are 7.8 million more women in America than men. If every man in America got married, there will still be 7.8 million who can't get husbands. And we know every man will never get married. You know that for so many reasons. So there are about 20 million more women in America who can't get husbands. 20 million. Who can't get husbands. What's the solution? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I said, what's wrong with you? Are you sick? The person is hungry, he says, hallelujah, and his stomach will be filled. The woman, she needs man, and he says, hallelujah, and she'll be satisfied. This is something wrong with you. You had, I give the figure, 44 million, 55 million, according to Jimmy Swaggart, who are drunkards. With all your born-agains, your Billy Graham, in his book, How to Be Born Again, he says there are 75 million born-again Christians in America. 75 million. That's about 1/3, is it? 1/3 of your population. I said, amazing. 1/3 of your nation is born again, immaculate, the spirit is in them, they can't be tempted. The old you, Swaggart says, is now left behind. You are a new you now. You are a new person. 75 million, 1/3. And it doesn't affect the population. You know, Jesus said, a little leaven leaveneth the whole. You need a little yeast to ferment the loaf. If 1/3 of your bread is yeast, and if it doesn't ferment the loaf, there's something wrong with your yeast or something wrong with your flour. Can you see? So I say, my dear child, I say there's something wrong with your flour. See? As well as your yeast. You haven't got it. You haven't got answers to the problem. So Jesus is telling you, I have yet many things to say unto you, but you cannot bear them now. Howbeit, when He, the Spirit of truth, is come, He will guide you into all the truth. And if I quote this verse again, with a little emphasis on the pronouns, you will see that it is not the Holy Ghost or the Holy Spirit or the spook that you are thinking about. Listen, Jesus says, I have yet many things to say unto you, but ye cannot bear them now. Howbeit, when He, the Spirit of truth, is come, He will guide you into all truth. For He shall not speak from Himself, but what things shall He hear, that shall He speak, and He shall declare unto you the things that are to come. He shall glorify Me. 8 masculine pronouns in one verse. I said, it ill befits a ghost, a spook, or a spirit. You agree? 8 masculine pronouns in one verse. He's talking about a man, a man, a man, a man, and not a ghost or a spirit. And He'll guide you into all truth, meaning He'll supply solution to all your problems. You haven't got them. Your surplus women, ask Jimmy Swaggart and your Falwell and your Billy Graham, ask them, what is the answer? Speechless. You haven't got the answer. So he hasn't written a book on polygamy. Swaggart, about surplus women, he doesn't write. Why doesn't he write? You know why? He's written more than 30. I own them. He won't touch this subject. You know why? You haven't got the answer. There are others very close. The answer is there, but he, as if he hasn't seen it. You know, Jesus said, seeing they see not, hearing they hear not, neither do they understand. About your sodomies and your lesbians, he's quoting a verse in his book on homosexuals. He starts that book, 2.5-page quotation. Imagine a quotation lasting 2.5 pages, first page, second page, and another half page, 2.5 page quotation from the book of Romans, in which he quotes, in those verses, he quotes the reason for this sickness. He's saying homosexuals, its cause and its cure. That's the title of the book. So he quotes, and I'm quoting now, he says, professing themselves to be wise, they're very clever people, they became fools and changed the glory of the imperishable God into an image like unto perishable man. The concept of God, you brought it down from that God Almighty, the Heavenly Father, omnipotent, eternal, immortal, you know, permeates the whole universe. From that concept you brought him down to the level of a man. And further, and changed the glory of the truth of God into a lie, and worship and serve the creature more than the creator. Look, it's so simple. Basic English. He's quoting 2.5. And he says, for this cause, I want you to read that. Romans. I forget the reference. It's the first Romans. Romans chapter 4, verse 22, 23, 24, yes. You read that. So for this cause, I made your women to go for women and your men to go for men. For this cause, he says, the cause and its cure. He's telling you, for this cause, what cause? You now brought God the Almighty down to the level of a man. You're serving a man instead of the Supreme Being. You're worshipping and serving a creature instead of the Creator. Now who is he talking about? You Christians! You are the one who brought God down to this level. You said God must come down to earth. He won't understand our problems otherwise. You know, he must understand how we feel. He's so loving, he came down to earth and he lived, born of a woman, carried him for 9 months, born like any other human child, circumcised on the 8th day. Growing like any other human being, eating food and call of nature, running to the toilet. God, you brought him down to that level. For that, God says, I give you punishment. Your women will become lesbians and your men become sodomites. Why don't you? Look, you read the whole book. And by God, he says, for this cause, the book says, its cause and its cure. That word is never used, as if you never read it. So Jesus said, seeing they see not, hearing they hear not, neither do they understand. They are already made up their minds. But this exercise, I say, is for those who have eyes to see, ears to hear. Let them hear. That look, you are not reading the book. When you be reading it, you misunderstanding it, you misinterpreting it. Please, do us a favor. I said, please talk to us. We want to have a dialogue with you. We want to talk to you. You see? And see our point of view. Maybe we are wrong. We want you to reprogram us as we want to reprogram you. But the language is me, myself. I just can't help it. I am born a militant fellow in a militant family. My father was militant. I am militant. My brothers are all militant. And I can't help it, you know. My voice, my size, everything, you know, creates that impression that I'm fighting you. I'm scolding you. But you know, my child, I'm not doing that. This is my nature. I just can't help it. So you'll forgive me for my tone, everything. But I mean well. Please.